Our eighth speaker of this evening creates a blend of storytelling and unique folk-inspired melodies. She is a Calgary-based singer-songwriter who writes about nearly anything but no love songs. Please welcome Kathryn Smith.
Diagnosed with Parkinson's disease, she organized a walk for us to raise money for Parkinson's awareness. And she also took me behind the scenes at the Calgary Zoo to look at tigers, which is just fun. And tigers are horrific animals. So that's a lot of rapid-fire examples of choices that I've made, how they've affected my life in the long run. I'm going to talk about something that happened more recently. 6 months ago, I had a full-time job as a production manager for corporate events in the city. So I have big rooms, like the one above, look like the one below. I was faced with a difficult choice after recording my first solo EP as a singer-songwriter, and I was wondering if I should go back to freelancing full-time as a scenic designer for theater and also to pursue songwriting. I would take a massive pay cut. I knew that a lot of people in my life would judge me for it, and it would be a lot of big life choices and changes. It means sometimes presenting in front of a room full of people just as Harry Potter, or playing on the street for a bunch of zombies. So I hummed and hawed over this decision for a long time. Eventually somebody said to me, "Kathryn, this isn't about anybody else. It literally only affects you." And once I come to terms with that, I tried to think about what my 10-year-old self would do, the person who wasn't afraid to dress up as a fictional character that they knew nothing about. And so I decided to go back to freelancing full-time. I quit my full-time job. And now I'm pursuing music and things that sometimes are more difficult, but it was a choice that I made to alter my life in the long run. It's a little impulsive, but I get to do things like pursue my my puppet musical that we do right over the summer at different fringe festivals. I get to play at many different festivals. I get to work with other theater companies in town. And as a result, I like to channel that inner child decision. I still haven't read all Harry Potter books. I don't plan on it. Most of my friends gasp at that decision. But a friend had pointed out to me a really excellent quote about choice from Harry Potter, which is, "It is our choices, Harry, that show what we truly are, far more than our abilities."